how many football players or basketball players go down to the court or to the field and stare at the field, as opposed to surfers go to the ocean and they stare at it, they wait. Well, today's not good, the wind's wrong, the swell's not quite here, swell direction is wrong, the spot's wrong. So it's all these things kind of come into place, and all of that to me is magical and it's powerful. Of course, surfing is a sport, but in a lot of ways it goes well beyond that. It's a lifestyle, it's something you do forever, and I guess I'm a pretty good case in point since I started surfing in 1960 at age 10. Luckily for me, my only sibling, my sister of 2 years older than me, was into it as well. So we surfed a lot in the Santa Monica Pacific Palisades area. And then with having my sister involved, it was wonderful because she was a beautiful young lady, and she had lots of boyfriends, and her boyfriends kind of had to take Bobby to the beach. It's a dance. You're trying to figure out exactly where you're going to go. So you're going real fast and then slowing down, going real fast and slowing down. When to get real fast, you get higher up on the wave and then slow down. You're doing turns, and it's just remarkable. It's like meditative in a sense, even though it's so physical.
The group in Shell Beach coined the phrase Helmet Bob. They saw me surfing at Shell Beach, and they're telling their pops, which I know a lot of the dads too. And then these young guys, they grew up with my kids, so I got to surf with them a whole bunch. And they would go, well, you know, Bob was out surfing at St. Anne's, and they say, well, what Bob? They go, well, you know, with the helmet. Thus I became either Helmet Bob or HB.
My dad's favorite spot in the world basically is Shell Beach right here at St. Anne's. It's a small day, so there's not much surf today, no one out, but if there was a swell whatsoever and my dad had the time, he would be here for the most part. Here in Pismo, but if there's a real swell and real waves, he would be here. And he's somewhat of a legend here, really. I mean, pretty much if you ask someone if they know the guy who wears a silver helmet and a Camelback backpack, they'll be like, oh yeah, Helmet Bob.
Catch waves and trading off waves with him is just what's special, you know. He's you know, into his 70s now. I know he's not going to be paddling out in huge days, but I've seen him out here on some pretty big days. He still does paddle out once in a while, and he's got his helmet on, and it's just fun. Anytime you get to surf with Bob, it's always fun. A lot of talking, a little bit of surfing, and a lot of smiles.
Uh, 18 years ago, I had pretty radical throat cancer. Lost my only sibling, my second mother. My first best friend, my sister, was an amazing individual. I lost her 7 years ago. I lost my niece 10 years ago. My wife was my angel when I was going through cancer. I would probably not have made it without her. And she went through a lot, and all caregivers, my hat's off and huge love to them. To me, one of the worst things in the world is cancer. And it's just, it's god awful. And so I've become, I guess, a cancer survivor, but I've been kind of a cancer crusader.
Well, the love of his family and his passion for surf was the reason that he got well and went back to surfing again.
He still had a feeding tube in his stomach, and he wanted to go surfing.
I said, you have to go surfing. You have to go surfing. And he goes, I don't know. And I said, well, I'll go with you.
So my mom wrapped him up in Saran wrap and duct tape, and we went to the beach.
And he caught a wave. just a little tiny wave. And I was running on the beach, yelling and screaming and hooting for him because he was up, he was surfing again. So it was wonderful.
We didn't go out too far, but he got that one wave and I was with him, and it was just pretty amazing. I mean, you know, who knew if he was gonna ever be able to surf again? And that was probably the moment that stood out the most in my life.
We've been able to start a program using surfing as the vehicle to create something magical and powerful to help people going through one of the worst things in the world by sharing one of the best things in the world. I really am so happy that I'm in this position to be able to try to help people by sharing simply what I've done all my life, and it works.